では、スペシャルレクチャーを始めます。Today's theme is religions and religious thoughts in Japan. What religion do you think Japanese follow?
Shinto.
Shinto?
Buddhism.
Christianity.
Confucianism.
Nothing. Atheist. Nothing. Okay. Yeah, almost correct. Let's see. According to Monkasho, Monkasho is Ministry of Education, Culture, Sports, Science and Technology. They surveyed it 2017 and said that 47% of Japanese follow Shinto, 47% Buddhist, 1%, only 1% is Christian, and others 5%. But I think that there is a very huge gap between the number of followers and actually they what they think about religious thought or what they think that they follow. So I did my own survey in 2015. I conducted a survey with 50 Japanese people. So they answered, do you believe in a particular religion? They answered that 7 people answered that yes, and 43 people said no. So question number 2. To whom answered yes? So 7 people. What religion do you believe? 4 said Buddhism and 3 said Christianity. So there was no Shinto. To whom answered no, which one does apply to you? Non-religious is 31%, atheist is 4%, and the others are 8. So you can see there are 2 categories, non-religious and atheist. Maybe you think that non-religion and atheist is a kind of same thing. But in Japan, the idea is a bit different. So to whom answered non-religious in question number 3, which does apply to you? A is that 23% people said that I don't believe in certain religions, but I think there is a sort of monotheist God. I mean, they believe gods. And B, 17 people or 55% people answer that I don't believe in certain religions, but I think there are many gods. So they think that there are many gods, but they don't follow a particular god. And see, I believe in plural religion at the same time. It also happens in Japan. For example, my mother's side house, they believe Buddhism and Shintoism at the same time. And these others. So here you can see that Japanese non-religion, the thought of non-religion and atheist and religion is a kind of, you know, a bit different from Indian. For example, in you all believe, if you say that I believe Hindu, it means you believe only Hindu, right? Not there is no other gods or Buddha or, you know, Allah or whatever. So that is the difference between, that is a very special idea in Japan. So you can see those fusion, religious fusion in Japanese culture. There are a lot of festivals and we follow the festivals in the year. This is Omisoka, New Year's Eve. we go to Buddhist temple and hear the hear the bell 108 times. And the next day, in the New Year's Day, we go to the shrine, Shinto shrine. And this is Shichigo-san, 3 years old, 5 years old, and 7 years old children has a particular festival. And they go to shrine. It's a kind of ritual to, you know, celebrate they grow up safely and healthily, and also pray the future, healthy future. And most of Japanese people nowadays have the reception and wedding ceremony in church. Some of them also have in shrine also. And when they die, they have the funeral in Buddhist style, most of the time. So you can see a fusion of various kind of religion at the same time in our life. So maybe you got confused that what kind of religious thought we have. So why it happens? Let's see. Oh, before that, I want to show you something like very local religious thought. Because from the ancient period, Japanese people believe that there are a lot of gods. We say that Yao Yorozu no Kami means 8 million gods. We believe that there are some gods in the big rock. There are some gods who lives in the trees, big trees. So it became, sometimes it came into the films also. You know this film? Mononoke Hime, Princess Mononoke. See that wild pig. Okkotonushi. It is a god of some forest. And this Moro, the wolf, also a kind of god. And you can see this small fairy that is Kodama. It's a kind of god in the forest. And also this is Shishigami. Shishigami is the most powerful god in the Mononoke Hime. This is a god of death and life. And what was that movie? Spirited Away. Yes. And that Haku, the dragon, is a god of a river. And this Totoro. Hi. Totoro is also a god. Also you can say ghost. This is the god of a mount, a small hill, or that particular forest. Do you remember this wood job? Okay. So here they worship the trees also, and they worship. They believe that some god. There is a some god in the mountain, right? Do you remember? I think. Momoe no Tegami. Those are called yokai. Yokai is a kind of god, and Japanese believe that there's a good god and bad gods, and kind of it's mixtured, but sometimes gods did some bad things. That time they call it yokai. Those gods are not so powerful, but sometimes they do some bad things to people, you know. And there are some gods came from India. What god do you think it is? Saraswati, yes. In Japan, we call it Benzaiten, but it is Saraswati. this is Daikokuten. Can you imagine what god it is? Shiva, yeah, or Mahakala, you can say. And this is Bishamonten. 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 So desu ne. So those gods came from India. And also you can see a very unique murti. This is Ganesh actually. We call it Daijizaiten. Daijizaiten. So those gods are also there in Japan. Now we are going to see the history of Japan, religion in Japan. From the ancient period, we believe, now they call it Shinto, but there is no that name that time. These two are the biggest temple, Shinto temple in Japan. The upper one is Izumo Taisha. It's in Hiroshima. And this is Ise Taisha. It's in Mie Prefecture. So those two are the biggest shrines of Shinto. And then Buddhism came into Japan, imported into Japan in 538 years, so 538, 6th century. And the Japanese government started to follow Buddhism as a national religion. So they made a lot of big temples in Japan. That is Todaiji. Todaiji has the biggest Buddha statue in Japan. And they, that time, you know, first they, some people protested to accept Buddhism. But slowly they mixed Shinto and Buddhism together, and it became a very unique kind of religion. It calls Shinbutsu Shugo. Okay, so that in Shinbutsu Shugo, we think Japanese, ancient Japanese gods are the guardian of Buddha or incarnate of Buddha. And then the second point, Christianity came to Japan. It came in 1549, I think, yes. And in the beginning, they allowed people to worship, follow Christianity. But slowly, when it becomes Edo period, they prohibited it because they think that, and they thought that Christianity, the idea of Christianity, the equal, they think that people are equal, right? That can make a big problem of Japanese system, or that time they have the class, right? So they thought that it will affect badly in that system. So they prohibited it. But some Japanese people still used to follow Christianity in this way. At the first sight, you see that, oh, this is a Buddhist statue, Buddha statue, or just Shinto kind of statue. But when you carefully see that is Mother Mary. You can see a small baby in her hand here. So that is Mother Mary. And this is, in the front side, it's a kind of monk, but at the behind, they draw a cross. So this is how they, covertly worshipped or followed Christianity. And in Meiji period, when the European countries came and forced to open up the door of Japan, Japanese government thought that they need a strong bondage of people and people's thought And that time, the government made national Shinto. They again pick up Shinto from the ancient period and said that this is our national religion, and the top god is Amaterasu Omikami, who is the ancestor of empire. Okay? And they forced people to follow national Shinto. But here again some trick came, a very big problem came, that European countries said that you must not follow one religion, because they thought that they would, Japanese government would prohibit Christianity, and it's not good for European country, right? So Japanese country that time, Japanese government finally said that, okay, national Shinto is not a religion. So they divided local beliefs and national Shinto completely, and the festivals, events, those kind of things related to Shinto became non-religious thing. That's why now in Japan, most of the people think that we are not religious. We are not following a particular religion. And you know, after the World War II, Japan had to completely give up national Shinto. And then they started to think, and also the liberty of, you know, following any religions are written in the constitution. So nowadays people think that we don't follow any particular religion, but inside our root there are a lot of religious thought and very rich religious, you know, belief and thought of following gods. So most of the time our culture is related to gods and religious beliefs and festivals, events. So I think when you go to Japan, if you have any chance to visit Japan, I hope you visit many shrines and temples and other festivals also, and you can see a lot of religious thoughts and beliefs there. Ashimai. Arigatou.